Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and welcome back to the channel, and welcome back to this quite short but amazing video where you can learn how to replace the boring print statement with some awesome print statements. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, now, why would you want to actually replace the print statement? Well, that is because it does not give you quite a lot of information when you try to debug your code. So let me just show you an example. So let me just create a new project here. So let's open up our test here, don't peek. Let's go to File, New, and Project. Okay, there we go. It will be a single view application. Let's click on next. I will name this, let's say, Swifty Print Demo. Okay, and make sure it's the language is Swift. Okay, let's click on next and drop it somewhere, anywhere on your desktop. I won't create a Git repository currently because you will be able to download the resources from the link down below, and I will talk about that in just a moment. So let's hit create now, and let me just resize this a little bit so you can see everything. Okay, now what you need to do first is go ahead and download the resources, and here you will find two files, and I will just drag and drop them into our project. And make sure copy items if needed is checked, create groups if checked, and Swifty print demo the target is also checked. So click on finish there, and we imported two files. First one is of course Swifty log that basically we are going to talk about in this lesson, and we have a dispatch queue helper. Now I have covered this handy little class in a separate video. Go ahead and search for it on my YouTube channel. I believe it is easy grand center dispatch GCD or something like that. Go ahead and take a look at it, and basically what this does is delays some functions in the completion handler by a number of seconds, and you can choose the dispatch level, the thread. May let it be the main or a background thread or a user initiated thread or whatever. We are going to use this because we want to show how this Swifty log is useful for your console. Okay, first of all, let's go to our view controller and let's create a simple print statement. Okay, let's go here, print, there we go. Let's select one of our simulators and hit Command B, or rather hit Command R to build and run, or just hit that play button there. And once the build has succeeded, we will see, just move this out of the way because it doesn't really matter, and have this right here. So this is a simple print statement. So that's what it is. It doesn't really convey anything else, when it was called, where it was called, on which thread, and that is where Swifty log comes in handy. Now I didn't really create a bot for this because we might want to set up some things, and let's just do that now. Let's go into Swifty log, and if you just scroll a little bit down, it's not a huge file, you can enable logs only for debug mode. Now there has been some debate about leaving or deleting your print statements in a release mode. Well, I believe that it should not be there because basically that is still executed when the app is launched on any device, and that takes up memory and so on. I believe that that should be the way to go. Leave print statements only in debug mode. Now here you have the steps, so we need to go to build settings, other C flags, and enter this dash D space debug, and you just need to copy this out just like I did right now for the debug flag, and then we can comment out these two flags. So let's go here and to build settings and type in, let me just go back again to double check, other C flags. Okay, there we go. Build settings, and in the search, other C flags. And as you can see, here it is. And if you tap on it, you will see this triangle, and just click on it and you will see debug and release. Now we want to add this flag only for the debug. So go ahead and paste that in there. There we go. That is basically it. And go to Swifty Log and comment out these two lines. Now, if we would be having this as a cocoa pod, then this would not be available. Okay, and of course you might not want to do this at all. Okay, let's go back to our view controller, and now we can fully have our log, Swifty log, enabled. And let's just type in here a new, let's say we have successfully launched the app by now, and let's just let me just go and walk you through the syntax. So what you need to type in is log and add a dot there. Okay, and as you can see, there are quite a lot of options here. Error, ln, that is a line, that is a simple print line. Success, to do, URL, and warning. And of course you can expand upon that, and I will just cover that once we do get the hang of how all of this works. So I will just call upon this success, and what we need to print in here is whatever we want to do. So, and as you can see, result of call to function returning logs is unused. Now, what you might do here is add this like so, and that will go away, and that is we usually do this, but this kind of looks ugly. So what you need to do instead is add a slash here at the end, and that will take care of it. So this is the syntax: log dot whatever you want, some string in there, and at the end this creates, well, it calls upon the function. Okay, so let's build and run again, and let's see what we do get here. Okay, and yay, a new emoji, and that is pretty awesome, because there will be a lot of lines in your console, and now you can basically visualize what just happened. With this check mark, you can see that something has successfully launched the app. Okay, now what else do we want to have here? Because yeah, it's good to have that emoji, but let me just give you the real power of our Swifty log. And what you want to do is add before the string that you want to add in here. Let's just add here a new property, and that is log.stats. And that is it. You want to have this all the time, and let me just print that out so you can see. So let's build and run again, and here you can really see the awesome power of what this can do. Okay, let me move that a little bit higher. So as you can see, there are a lot more, there is a lot more data. M means that we are on the main thread. Here is our date, and if you kind of take a look at the logs that other like frameworks add, there's a lot of clutter there. Now basically what I'm interested in is the date, so on what date we are, maybe the month, but that's just maybe. I don't really care about the year, and the time that we are in, because sometimes I try to figure out some things about on which second this got triggered. Now the other part, when we are debugging the code, is where did this print statement take place? So in the view controller, in the view, that is the file name, view did load is the function, and on the line 18, and that is some awesome power for you to log and of course debug. And of course the message successfully launched the app. Now that is some awesome. So let's take a look at some other, let's call these properties, the log properties. So let's add a new one here. Let's see, a log dot, and I will create a warning here. So let's see, warning, and I will just create our log stats here, log.stats, and let's add in here like something, you know, the game of baseball, strike one, strike two, strike three, you're out. So that is what we are going to do here. So let's add in here, I need to add that in here, so strike one. Okay, so let's see how that looks. Okay, oh, I need to initialize it and build and run again. Okay, let's just wait for that to compile. And as you can see, here we have this nice emoji and everything as it was in the success log. Okay, strike one. But of course we want to wait a little bit, so that is why I am going to use now the dispatch queue helper. That is pretty simple. So dispatch queue helper, there we go, and just type in delay, and I want to call this on the main thread, so I won't bother using the second one. I'm just going to use the automatic one, and that uses the main thread. So let's wait for 1 second and let's use the completion there and add our log in there by copy and pasting it there. So let's build and run again, and now we should see a 1 second delay, and there we go, here it is. Okay, in strike one, pretty awesome. Let me just get rid of this because it's kind of useless and we can see even more. So let's do all of these for strike two. There we go. And let's delay by 2 seconds and strike two. But for strike three, we want to do something else. We want to use the error. Let's see, we had an error like strike three, you're out, or out if I can add that space incorrectly. And we don't want a warning, we want an error here, and that is pretty awesome. We just changed the log property, and let's just build and run and see how all of this really logs out. So there we go, 1, 2, 3, you're out. And as you can see, here is our awesome error emoji and all of the details. Now this is valuable stuff, as you already know if you are debugging, and I know it's kind of lame debugging with print statements, but I do it all the time and I know you do it all the time, so yeah, why not do it in style. So what else do we want to do here? Well, as you can see, all of these are on the main thread, and well, main thread, it can be easily debugged, but what if we have something going on the background? Like, let's say there is a delay on downloading an image. So let's say upon our first, after we have successfully launched the app, we are starting an image fetch, and that takes, let's see, 4 seconds. So let's imitate that with our dispatch queue helper and delay, and I will choose this second one now with the dispatch level, because I want to do this on the background thread. Well, fetching usually fetches a background thread, let's say for Firebase, we're downloading an image, so that is handled on the background thread. So let's do this delay for 4 seconds, and the dispatch level will be dot background. And the completion, now let's add a log in here. So that is 4 seconds that took, and maybe we want to work on this. So we are going to use another property here, and that is to do. And let's add in here first the log stats, log.stats, And let's add in here fix this delay issue next week. Okay, now this is a to-do, or maybe you just want to do something else, and let's initialize it, let's call it like that. Okay, and again, this is an example for the background thread and for the to-do, because why not? We are going to do those two examples in one. So let's build and run and see how all of this works. As you can see, the background thread is called before, so we are waiting 4 seconds, and there we go. We are not on the background thread, on the main thread, so not M is displayed here. If you are seeing this as an exclamation mark and a quality sign, then that means that you haven't already added Atom 1 dark theme to your Xcode, and go ahead and do so. Go ahead and take a look at my video on how to do that. Let's call these characters, are so much easier to read, and of course all of these two and these. And if you are taking a look at this, first line 18, 25, 29, 33 are executed, and only then line 21. So this is a really good thing to know how to debug. Okay. And I believe that is basically it. We do have some other properties, so let's take a look at them and how you can improve upon this and do your own logs. So let's go to Swifty Log and go ahead and add in here a case for anything that you want. Maybe you want a URL or something else, a new line. Oh, let me just show you the new line before we go move in, because that is maybe what you will use in most of the cases, if not some. So let's see here. This will be a dispatch queue helper after, let's see, 5 seconds, and it will be a line, a simple line. So what we want to print out here is logging at its best. Okay, so let's build and run one final time and see all of the logs here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, and there we go with the background thread and the main thread. It is a pencil here. Okay, logging at its best. So let's take a look at how you can expand this Swifty log. And as you recall, you can add in here a new case with a string. I recommend a string because it's much easier to work with. And if you add a case here, you must go ahead and add that case to our switch statement. And that is basically pretty easy. You just call upon this log function, add in your emoji, and call this initialize let, let's call this a URL, or whatever you will add to extend upon this. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified about new videos as they do come up. Now, it is your turn. Go ahead and comment down below. Do you use print statements or this new Swifty log to debug your code? Go ahead and comment down below. And as always, I will see you in the next one.